Hello guys, welcome back to this channel and thanks for viewing this video. So today we are going to continue our discussions on Java graphical user interface components. So previously we talked about frames and then we talked about labels. Now it's high time for us to talk about buttons. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a button using the class JButton. And I'm also going to show you how to add that button to your frame. So this is how my project is organized. I have two classes. The first class is the main class where I have my main method. The second class is the class that I called my frame. And I'm using this class to actually be able to create a frame object. And to do that, I am making sure that the class my frame is inheriting all the properties and methods from the Java class JFrame. And here I'm defining all the properties of my frame. So I'm going to be writing the code for the button inside this MyFrame class. And in the main class here, in the main method, I am creating my frame object of type MyFrame. So as I said, if you want to create a button using Java, you have to use the Java class called JButton. So this class, JButton, will also help us control various attributes of the button object. So the code that you need to write to create a button in Java GUI is JButton, and then the name of your button, I'm going to call it BTN, equal new JButton. So what I have done here is that I have declared a button and I have also instantiated it. So I need to import the button class, JButton class, and now it's okay. If you want to add this button to your frame, all you need to do is to say this, that add the button. We call it BTN. So this is going to make sure that your button is added to the frame. Let me see if the button has been added. When I run, so as you can see, the button has occupied the whole space of the frame. So if you want to fix that, one thing that you can do is to actually set the bounds of the button. So I'm going to say BTN, that's the name of the button, set bounds. So this is going to determine the position of the button and then its size. So let me say 100, 100. So these parameters are for the coordinates, the X coordinate and the Y coordinate, and it's going to determine where the button will be placed. And now I can add two more parameters that will refer to the width and the height. So I will say 100, 100. So now when I come and run, this is still not going to take effect because we have not specified the layout. So the frame layout is given by default. So we need to set the layout of our frame to null. So I'll come here and say this at set layout null. So this is going to make sure that no layout is specified for the frame. So now when I will run, this setBound method is actually going to take effect. Okay, now you can see that I have my button showing on the frame. So I can reduce this, say 50 like this. And this one I can say 200, 200. When I run, you can see now where the button is being placed. Okay, so this is on how you can add your button to your frame. So you have to declare and instantiate your button, and then you add it here. This is the line. And when you run the program, you will see that the button would occupy the whole space of the frame. And if you want to reduce that or fix that, what you need to do first is to set the layout to null. And then you can now set the bounds of your button. So the bounds is used if you want to set the position of your element on the frame, and then its width and height, so its dimensions. So that's it. There are certain other methods that we can look at. So we are going to manipulate certain attributes of the button. Let's say, for example, you want to set the text of your button. So there are two ways to do that. You can do that directly when instantiating your button. So let me say, for example, here I would say the text of this button would be button text, something like that. So when I run, you will see that now some text will appear on the button. As you can see here, I have the button and then I have some text. Okay. Or the other way you can set the text of the button is to use the setText method. So you can simply say btn that set text, and inside you say this is my button, like this. Now when you come and run, you'll see that the text will appear. So let me increase the width of the button so that we will see the entirety of the text showing on the button. Yeah, so this is my button, so that the text we just set right now. So let's talk about more methods that we can use to manipulate our button attributes. When you run, for example, you will see that the text of the button is surrounded by, you know, a box. It's inside a box. Okay, so if you want to remove that from the button, all you have to write will be button.setFocusable. You say false. So it takes a Boolean value. So that's going to be either true or false. So if you say false, now when you run, you know, there is no more border surrounding the text of your button. So that's the method setFocusable. So we can also set the font of our button text. So we can define the font family, the font style, and even the font size of the button text. So we will say btn that set font, and inside the bracket we will write new font, and we will say consolas. So that's the font family, comma. We need to define the font style. So we will say bold, and then the font size, let's say 28. So now when we come and run, you can see that the text of our button is now bold. Let me just reduce the text here. Simply say button, for example, so that when you run, you can see the text showing, and that the font family and the font style we defined here is actually working. We can also change the color of the button text. So we will say btn that set foreground. So these are basically the very same, some of the methods we also used when we were controlling the attributes of the label. Okay, so I can say that I will give it the color red. Now when I refresh, now you can see that my button text is red. So what if I want to change the background color of the button? So I will say btn at set background, and in here I will say color that black. Okay, so this is going to change the color of my button. Let me run and see if this will happen. Now you can see that my button is having a background color of black and the text is red. We can also play around by saying that, okay, we want to add some border to the button. So what we need to do here, we will say btn at set border and border factory that create etched border. So this line of code is actually going to set some border to our button. Let me run. Okay, so this is going to add some border. So when you click, you can see that this is actually a button. When you press your mouse button, you can see the border showing. When you release it, you can see the background color coming to normal. What if you want to disable the button? Okay, so if you want to disable a button, you can use the setEnabled method. So you write button setEnabled to false. So this particular method takes Boolean value. So it can either be true or false. So if you say false, that means that the button will be disabled. If you say true, the button will be enabled. So by default, your button is enabled. So now here we said false. Now you can see that we cannot click on the button, so the button is disabled. And even the color of the text is not picking. But if we say true here and then run our program, yeah, the button can be clicked on. So we can also use the pack method. And what we're gonna do is that we will comment this and the size as well. So in the previous video, I told you that the pack method that we can apply on the frame will make sure that the frame is resized according to the element it contains. So I'm going to comment the size and the layout. And at the end here, I'm going to say this pack like this and then semicolon. So that means that the frame is going to have the size according to the size of the button, okay? I also need to comment the set bounds like this. Now, if I come and refresh and run my program, you can see that the size of the frame is now equal to the size of the button. So whenever I increase the dimension of the frame, I'm also increasing the dimension of the button. So there are various methods that we can actually talk about, but we will stop here. If you have any question, feel free to write in the comment section and I'll be more than willing to answer your questions. And I hope this video was informative, and please don't forget to like, to share, and to subscribe to this YouTube channel to help us and to support us. So let's meet in the next video.